Crash Test Radio, Q101.1, Ryan and Kevin Mano with Jax Mannequin. I know you said you don't call yourself
Jax Mannequin.
Andrew McMahon.
Yeah, how you doing?
Good, man.
Good to see you, dude. I think last time we saw you, you did that like a little special free show for us at the Beat Kitchen.
Beat Kitchen, yeah, yeah. Absolutely. Oh,
that was
awesome.
That was a great show.
That was so much fun, man. I love doing that kind of stuff. I love doing the small clubs. And yeah, that show was no exception. It was awesome. Really cool.
Yeah. How are you doing? Are you good? Everything's good with you?
$1 million, man.
You look good.
Everything. I feel great. Everything is, the clock's ticking. Everything's good. You know what I mean? I feel just fine. Yeah.
Good.
Yeah, absolutely.
That's good news.
Thank you. Yeah, thank you very much.
So you have new music?
Yes. Finally.
Yeah.
It's been a long time.
Did it take you longer than you wanted?
Yeah. I think because of the ordeal, as I've come to call it, you know, when I got sick during the last record, it sort of, you know, it sidelined. I was really psyched to put the Everything in Transit record out. It was just like, it was my baby. I had worked on it. I was really passionate about it. And then obviously, you know, getting taken out right before we really got to go out and swing the bat and promote it, you know, it just bummed me out. We sort of tried to reset the clock back to day one on that album and, you know, pretty much toured it for...
That's admirable.
Yeah, I mean, we toured it for like 2.5 years.
Yeah,
really,
you were on the road. I felt like you were always...
I mean, we never really stopped. I think maybe the crux of why this took a little bit longer to make was that, you know, I was kind of doing it simultaneously while I was trying to you know, still promote the other album.
Yeah.
So, I mean, there were points, you know, over the course of the past year where it was finally like, okay, we got to just focus on this thing. So, yeah, it took a while, but, you know, it was a hard-fought battle, but one I'm glad we fought. You know?
I do want to ask you one thing, because I haven't seen the whole thing, but Dear Jack, where can people find that? I've seen pieces of it, and it seems like one of the most emotional things.
The Dear Jack thing is like a... you know, it's funny. It's a heavy thing. I mean, for me to even watch it truthfully is like a pretty tough thing. You know, the whole idea behind it was, you know, I had been filming like a video journal really with the purpose of just documenting the making of the Transit record. You know, mm-hmm. I had like, you know, at that point I was separated from my girlfriend, now wife. And, you know, I had like...
Congratulations.
Yeah, thank you very much. And I had gotten to this place where I had gotten really comfortable with this handheld video camera, you know what I mean? And I would at the end of the night, I would flip the thing on and be like, this is what the day was like today. And even if you listen to the first Jax record, a lot of those little spoken word segments that mm-hmm. you pick up in the record are all taken directly off my handheld camera that I was filming all this sort of like, you know, journaling all the making of the record. And then when I got sick, I had still sort of had this rapport with my camera. And I think some of the things that were a little bit harder to talk about and a little bit harder to process, I did so with
yeah,
the camera,
sure,
you know,
definitely.
It seemed like, okay, well, if, you know, somebody thinks this is an important story and all of a sudden, you know, I have these tapes, maybe it is worth mm-hmm. worth telling. Because it was such an accidental recording, you know,
yeah.
I think you don't really see, there are aspects of what happened, you know, that I don't think people have really gotten a chance to see firsthand. You know, I've seen sort of reality-based shows about people dealing with things, you know, dealing with issues, sicknesses, or being in the hospital and stuff, and, you know, and they're incredibly moving, but it's taken, you know, there's a crew, and there's lights, and there's all these things. I mean, this is about as raw as it could be, you know, like, you know, having people, you know, perform procedures and, you know, and on my right arm while I'm filming it with my left arm, mm-hmm. you know what I mean? And things like that, that is like, it's heavy, but I think, you know, the fact that I'm still here, you know, the hope is that the film, you know, people will see that there's a lot of hope in dark times, and there's a lot that you can take from that item.
Where can we find it?
Well, I'm, you know, at this point, I know we've got sort of two different people within, or two different groups within my world, management and agency and label and everybody working various different angles from a broadcast perspective, maybe to get one of the music stations to air it, whether it's a streamlined version or not, mm-hmm. or if they break it up into a series, you know, to get it out on like MTV or Fuse or
VH1
or one of those stations. So that'll, I imagine its first home will be a broadcast on mm-hmm. one of the networks.
Isn't really just one of the coolest parts about life is that, like you said, no matter how bleak things seem, like there's always the potential for hope.
Absolutely.
Isn't that cool? Like,
it gives you something to live for, you know what I mean? Yeah, absolutely.
And we all get caught up. We all think that our problems are so, you know, just heavy and like, I'm never going to get out of this, but...
Yeah, well, I think it's relative, you know? It's like, I mean, it's a hysterical thing because it's like, when I was sick, it was like, I'm never going to honk my horn again. I'm never going to... You know what I mean?
Yeah.
You have this, you get this perspective, you think that you're going to live the rest... You know, if you survive this, you're going to live your rest of your life as like some sort of sage because you've seen the other side or
right.
something. And the reality is, it's like, I honk my horn still, you know what I mean? And it's hard, you know, you become accountable, you know, it makes you a little bit more accountable to things like that. But I think everybody's problems are relative, you know what I mean? It's like you get a bad day at work, you know, on one day can feel worse than encountering That's right. something really heavy on another day, because I think you modify your approach and your perspective based on each situation.
Well, it's good that you're sitting here next to us.
Yeah, it's good to be here, man. Yeah,
it really
absolutely.
Is.
Thank you very much.
I want to put the trailer for the documentary on our blog at q101.com. Awesome. So everyone can go right now and
Please
see what
do.
We're talking about. It's very emotional.
It seems like, you know, finally for once, you know, we've got people paying attention to what we're doing. And I know we're, you know, for us, after the year that we spent making this record, it's exciting to see people actually reacting and getting fired up for it.
Good.
So,
well, congratulations, man. You deserve it.
Really.
I appreciate it very much.